tiêu đề 4 Power Series, số 4 Power Series, You Will Have Realized Optimistry in the Meaning. First, we will change the ratio A to S. Next, this number we will change into different number. Here you see A, same A. You can take A outside. But for general geometry, you will have here A0, A1, A2, they are different. So that means student, power series, you have that form. C0 plus C1S plus C2S square plus C3S cube. The main question of power series, we will find S, so this series converge. The set of on S where this series converge, we will say domain of conversion. But in fact, we will show slightly easier question. We find only interval. Why? We talk about interval. Student, if we that special case when on CK equal 1, so when you substitute here, on will be 1, 1, 1, 1. So you have the series 1 plus S plus S square. And you say this is geometric. 1 plus S plus S square plus S cube plus similarly. This is exactly S geometric. The ratio R now this is S. So your series converge if and only if absolute size of S smaller than 1. That means S between minus 1 and 1. So this is the open interval. Inside that interval, your series surely converge. Understand? We can show in general case student, we can find the number A. So when S between minus A and A, your series surely converge. Do you understand? And this open interval, we talk, we say interval of conversion. How we find the interval of conversion? Now, I like to return to power series. When you have power series, you must touch absolute size of n. How? From A power N, you can find the number absolute size of A. You see here you have N root. Below you don't have root, you don't have power. Do you understand? Here you have power N. Below you don't have power. How you cancel one power? You touch root. You touch N root, so the power cancel. This is the test that we want you to remember. If you have power series, please touch N root of absolute size of general term. Let this limit smaller than one. And so this inequation you will have S between minus R and R. To find this limit, I like you to remember two basic limits. Limit of number P and N root of N. More general, you can use the limit like that. 1 plus A power N. When N comes to this thing, this is exponential of A. Okay, now, student, TLC, this means interval of conversion. And we ask you to find the greatest integer number inside that interval of conversion. So question A, when you recognize this power series, just that n root of absolute size, and that's the limit. Now let's say what I do, student. First, n the root of n, and the little positive, so you can touch n outside. Below, n the root of power, this is 2 n plus 1 n. And the last, spend attention here, as you don't know positive or negative, or you just remember n the root of absolute size of s power n, this is absolute size. I very usually use this symbol identity, n the root of absolute size of s n power n, this is absolute size of s. And now how you find this limit, student? About this number comes to 1. Below that power n plus 1 over n comes to 1. So this is 2 power 1. And this is the constant. You don't have n ở đây. You let this limit smaller than 1. So you have absolute size of s smaller than 2. That means S between minus 2 and 2. And as we ask you the greatest integer number, you will get the answer, this is 1. Now, the next question will be more difficult. This is the most complex limit that you will be asked in the enter. Anyway, you repeat the same identity. Okay, to save some time, you can spend attention. This factor, minus 1 power n plus 1, is just plus 1 or minus 1. So when you take absolute size, surely this number will be 1. Don't worry about minus 1 power something. Do you understand? When you take absolute size, surely this factor will be cancelled. So remaining only the first factor, the next factor, so now the first and the root of that s power n, this absolute size of s. Below, 3 n plus 2 over n. And n the root of this term, this is power n square. So you have n. Understand? Now, student, You can see immediately this limit. This is constant. This is easy limit. So fly very fast. We will fly that limit outside, and we spend all our attention to the last term. Do you understand? This is the key. This is the most difficult section in this question. So ask yourself as constant and conflicting and plus 2 over and control 1. So we bring 3 outside. Understand? Now we will spend attention that term. How we find this limit? This one in my square, when n come to retail, you will have inside this one, outside this retail, and one power retail related to number e. You must use the limit of number e. To do that, first you must rewrite the expression inside the bracket so you have number 1 a bit. Here we have n minus 1. This is n plus 1 minus 2. So you have 1 plus minus 2 over n plus 1. Do you see? But I like to recall you the basic limit for number e. When you have 1 already in the bracket, above you have constant, below you have something comes to be there. So the power here and the below there, they must be the same. So if you have n plus 1 here, so power must be n plus 1. Understand? To use number e. But your limit here is n, but you have n plus 1 inside. So you must change outside, you will have n plus 1. So you can see inside the bracket, you have the same. After multiplying, you have the same power n. Do you understand? We must take care so the number e appears there and the limit will be absolutely like before. And now it is easy. How about the limit inside bracket still done? This is exponential of minus 2. Do you see? I hear this is number minus 2. And outside, the power here comes to 1. So you have your limit is like that. And let the limit smaller than 1. So you have absolute size of S smaller than 3 exponential 2. That means S between 3 exponential 2 minus 2, 3 exponential 2. Let's find this number by calculator. This is about 22. Understand? And student, we ask you the greatest integer number. So your final answer will be 22. Okay. We can ask you the smallest integer number. If we ask you the smallest integer number, this will be minus 22. So you must read carefully the question. But your solution based on the basic limit like that. That I read. Do you understand? The process is similar for both. Good, if you understand, so this is also the last topic today. Now let's spend 3-4 last minutes to start one numerical example of similar questions.